Hi, welcome to the worship experience at River of Life Ministry. I'm Pastor Joyce Newman, and I know you're going to be blessed. So engage and receive in Jesus' name.
I'm going to lift my hands till I can reach heaven. I'm going to shout your name till the walls come falling down. I've come to worship. I've come to worship. I'm going to sing my song like I am unashamed. I'm going to shout your name at the mention of your name. I've come to worship. I've come to worship.
Let's do it again.
I'm going to lift my hands till I can reach heaven. I'm going to shout your name till the walls come falling down. I've come to worship. I've come to worship.
I'm going to sing.
I'm going to sing my song like I am unashamed. I'm gonna
shout for joy
at the mention of your name. I've come to worship. I've come to worship.
God, we have come to worship you tonight. And Lord, we have come to grow in relationship with you. You're the great I Am, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and there's none like you. I thank you, Father, that you are here with us tonight. I thank you that your plan is good. I thank you, Lord, that you never turn your back on us. I thank you that you are the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega. I thank you that you are Elohim and El Shaddai. I thank you that you are God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. I thank you that you are Jehovah Rapha, the Lord our healer. I thank you, God, that you are Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. Hallelujah. I thank you, God, that you are Jehovah Tsidkenu. You are our righteousness. In Jesus' name. I thank you, God, that you are Jehovah Sabaoth, and that is the Lord of hosts. You are above everything, and every knee has to bow to you. You are awesome. You are magnificent. And Lord, we surrender to you tonight, spirit, soul, and body. God, open our hearts and minds to hear what the Spirit of the living God has to say. Lord, we want to grow. We want to be free. God, we want more. So we thank you, Lord, that we will receive that tonight. Because it says if we come after you, if we seek you with all of our hearts, we will find you. And Lord, here we are. We're going to lift our hands till I can reach heaven. I'm gonna shout your name till the walls come falling down. I've come to worship. I've come to worship. I'm gonna sing my song like I am unashamed. I'm gonna shout for joy at the mention of your name. I've come to worship. I've come to worship. Amen. High five somebody as you're sitting down. Woo! Woo! How's everybody tonight? Right? Did everybody come expecting? Because if you came expecting, you're going to find the Lord. If you come expecting, you're going to find what you're looking for. Now, I don't know that you're going to get everything that you want, but definitely God's going to give you what you need. Amen.
Okay, so I had like a paper,
and I'm not finding it, so just, here it is. Okay. So today, I'm kind of excited. First of all, I thank you, God, that you are in me. I thank you, Father, that I am forgiven. I thank you, Lord, that I am in you and you are in the Father. I thank you that I am in a place of peace, in a place of protection. I thank you, Lord, that no matter what's going on around me, even though I walk through the waters, they're not going to overtake me. I thank you that your promises are yes and amen. I thank you, God, that you're only going to continue to move the way that you move. You're the great I am. In Jesus' name, all God's people said.
Amen.
Amen. Yesterday was kind of a pretty big day, actually, for me as a pastor and as a woman of God, because the Lord had asked me to call the ministers of Manistee, the city of Manistee, together. And I know that when God asked me to do that, the first thing that I wanted to do was be like, you know, God, are you sure that you're calling the right person? But I want to tell you something. There's this vision that God placed on my heart. And the vision that he gave me, and it could only be God. It's nobody else but God, because I don't think this way. I don't think about stuff like this. But what he showed me is that God, and we know this, that Christ is the head of the church, right? But what the Lord showed me is that there's dominions and there's areas all over. When you're in a plane, you can see all the mapped out areas, right? You can look at a map and you can see. The Bible talks about dominions. It talks about how principalities have powers over dominions. They're set over Manistee, right? Okay, so two of the main demonic sources, and they have ranks, just like we have on earth. Two of them over Manistee was religion and addiction. People would say, hey, you know, Manistee is known for its churches and its bars. Hello. So, but I want to tell you that has changed. That God has come in like a flood, and he has been doing some things. He's raised up... and I'm just going to talk about River of Life tonight, because this is what I know about us. I don't know about everybody else, but I know what God said about us. And he said that whenever these things are dominant in an area, he's going to raise up a church by his Spirit to bring down the principalities. Amen. Right? Okay, so what did he do? He raised up a church called River of Life Ministry. We didn't even know what we were doing, but we knew that we loved God and we were going to let him build the church. And he's continued to build it, and he's going to continue to build it. And we're not denominational. I am not against denominations. That's not it. But God did not want us to be that. He wanted us to take out a step of faith and trust him to create the church to be what he wanted it to be without a cap of the do's and don'ts. Okay, the Spirit of God, there are do's and don'ts, but if you know him and you walk with him, he'll show you these. Okay, so, and the other thing that he gave us, which is a huge blessing to us, is we have favor in the spirit realm dealing with people with addiction. It's not just drugs and alcohol. It's sexual addiction, and it's pornography, and it's so many. Addiction is addiction. I don't care what you say. It is what it is. And so, but what God has done is he's delivered so many of us, and the church just continues to grow. But what we do is, because we can relate, we can help, right? And so now down the road, he's got something else for them, because they're a different part of the body. But they're still part of the body, right? This is just our part, and this is what God has shown us. And I know without a doubt, I've seen it. I even see the evidence of it, how the power of God is bringing down the strongholds that have been over this city. How do I know that? One is that the bars are closing and have closed all over this community.
Amen.
That's one. And the other is that God has brought in, and I'm not saying anything about anybody that has left, because they were called by God and their season was up. There's a reason, a season and a lifetime. And so we have to be okay with that. And so God moved out some ministers and brought in all brand new ministers. There's more new ministers in this community than there is old. And that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. I just see a shift. So yesterday, we had that meeting and we had it here, and I was scared because, you know, we all have come out of the world, but you know, when you know your past and you look at people of the Lord, I don't care if you're a pastor or not, you know, you're like going, I don't think I can do this, you know. I admire the Spirit of God in other ministers, absolutely. And I think, how on earth do they do that? I can't do that. But see, I have to be satisfied and alive in what God does through me. And that's why I teach the body that we don't want to be anybody else. When you're called to be the foot, you be the foot. When you're called to be the finger, you be the finger. Because if you try to be somebody else's part, we're not going to be able to function. So the vision that God gave me was the clergy, the ministers of the gospel over this community, were to come together as God, as Jesus Christ, the head of the church. And he showed me in the spirit realm that what would happen is only the chosen would come. They will come. And what will happen is unity will come, and we will be the different parts of the body over this domain, over this community. And because we're under the headship of Jesus Christ, and each one of these ministers come together and pray for each other and pray for the community and the needs of the community, and we're walking as our own parts of the body. It's not about what they preach or they do or don't do, and they have this outreach and they're evangelistic and they do missions. It's not that. That's not what God said. He says, just come together and let me be the head and let you leaders be the church, the body of Christ. And then God's going to send us back to our bodies of Christ that he has set us over. And so what's going to happen is it's like when you take a shower and, you know, you get under the shower and it hits your head and it feels so great. And then it hits your shoulders. It's awesome. It goes down your back and your legs all the way to your feet. You know, and I don't know about you, but I let it get my feet when my feet are cold, because if my feet are cold, my whole body's not happy. Right. And so our feet are important. But anyways, that's just me. But the thing is when you're in a shower and that water goes down, I want you to picture the head of Christ that way. So I kind of envision Jesus, the head, the pastors coming together over this community, and I'm going to call them the shoulders. And then from the shoulders down is all of you guys. And I believe that God is on the move, and I believe that he's going to do something spectacular all over the world, but I'm only part of this community and here. But yet what he's done is he's brought people here from all over the nations to be poured into the truth of the Word of God and to bring you into a place of freedom so that you can go back and start fires where you're at. Because this is what is so cool is the new people, and thank you for coming for the first time. And every week we ask, but I want you to know that you're kindling. That when you come, we're already a fire, but when new people come, our fire increases. And it's not about the numbers, but it's about the fire, you see. Because what happens is the fire in all of us gets on everybody else, and what happens is it gets roaring. Right? And so that's what's supposed to be happening. So I pray in every community, every church in Manistee County gets new people this week. And I pray all over the nations, new people come in. But I pray that the people that are already there knows how to handle the new people. It's important. So yesterday was so awesome because, you know, we had some people that came and some that weren't able to come that want to be part of this, and it's okay. But one of the things that the Lord just did this with me really quick. We were talking to a young man who's totally on fire for God. And he's a young minister, a family of four. He don't look old enough to have four kids. But it was just awesome. And one of the things that he said is, I'm free. And he's in a denomination church, but he is on fire for God. So don't be afraid of those, okay? What you look for is the Spirit of the living God. That's what you look for. Okay? That's what you look for. So anyways, he says, yeah, I'm free. And the Lord just did one of those like things in me like, okay, you need to get this. I get it, but he wanted me to get it more. And I'm like, okay, so tonight when we were here and you hit freedom, and that's where we're going tonight. So that was even confirmation. So I'm thinking, okay, God. And you know what he said? He goes, you know why I'm free? Because I'm forgiven. Yeah. And okay, we know that, but do you know it? Has it went the 12 inches from the brain to the heart? Do you know it in your knower? Are you ready to go out and let people know that you're free? You know, I used to hear people say, I can't wait till you get free. Or even Christians say, I can't wait till you get free. And I get what you mean, but now I get it better. Because just one word. And I've heard this over and over again. But God knows when the fire needs to roar. And he says the fire needs to roar at River of Life Ministry. And people need to go from head to heart. And they need to understand that they're free. Yeah. You're free completely. If you know, you are forgiven. Right? And so we have to know that we're forgiven. How do we know we're forgiven? Because God says, amen. The B-I-B-L-E, that's the book for me. Somebody said, you probably don't know that. Somebody was saying it one day. I said, yes, I do. And I started saying it. I'm saying it here. I think it's kind of cool because it is the book for me. So anyways, I was like, God, it's all over the Word of God. Where do you want me to go? What do you want me to do? Everybody knows this. He goes, no, they don't. Because I wouldn't have you up there reminding them that know it. That don't really know it, because I know it, but I just got fire with it now. That's when it becomes alive. That's when your eyes get bright, and that's when you want to tell people, and that's when you want to dance, and that's when you want a glimpse of eternity. It's because why? Because you're free. Why? Because you know you're forgiven. You know what? When we say, ask people to forgive us, and they say, yeah, you're forgiven. You don't have to prove it, that you don't got to work for the forgiveness. It's there. It's given. That's from Christ. And Christ is in us. So when we forgive, we just forgive. But some people have a hard time. And they say, well, you know what? You owe me. Well, if they owe you, they don't understand their own freedom. They don't understand their own forgiveness. Because you don't have to make it better. I realize that sometimes we have to pay price for some things that we've done. Okay, I get that. Okay, recompense. Is that the right word? That's what's coming to me, so I hope it's right. So, but this is the thing. In that, even when you have to pay for some things, you still have confidence from the Spirit of the living God that you're forgiven. And that's what I'm here to talk about tonight. And that's what I want you to be jumping about tonight. And that's what I want you to take out with you tonight. And I want you to go to those people whose their heads are hanging down. And I remember when Brittany came, she was sitting right where you're at. And I remember telling her that, and I lifted up her head. And I told her that he is her glory and the lifter of her head. If you can get that in your heart, from your head to your heart, and you understand that, your heads will come a whole lot higher. And not with a puffed out chest is pride, but oh my gosh, I'm loved and I'm forgiven and he wants my head up and I don't have to be ashamed, right? We lift our hands, right? We sing for joy. We shout for joy. We can't wait. Why? Because we're forgiven, right? So this is where I want to go. Please go with me really quick to Psalms 91. Let's just go there. So everybody pick up the Bibles. They're the same here. We're going to kind of move around tonight, and I'm just going to let God do what he does because he's the best. So tonight when I got in here and I was asking the Lord, you know, throughout the day, and today, tonight, Lord, what do you want to hear in worship tonight? Because, you know, you just can't keep up with the new songs, and I like the old songs, but it's not about what I like or anybody else likes. It's what God wants us. He knows what we need to sing. He knows where it's going to make a difference in our hearts. He knows, and there's times he wants to hear certain things. He loves it when we're lifting up our hands and saying, I just want to touch the sky. You know, and he loves that we just want to shout for joy. And he loves that, how great is our God. He loves that. I will worship. He loves that. So anyways, worship belongs to the Lord. And worship is so many different things. But tonight I said, God, to go. And so for the very last song, and I know we've been singing Place of Freedom. And we've been singing, and what we do, God has us sing the same songs for a while because you need to learn them so that you can shut your eyes, so they can get in your spirit, so that when you're going through the trials and tribulations or you wake up in the middle of the night, you're singing in your in with the Spirit of the living God. You're singing within you. I just want to lift my hands till I can reach heaven. I'm going to shout your name. And it's just going, and you wake up in the middle of the night, you're like, wow, can I tell you that that is the Spirit of the living God connected to your spirit? And you're so out of it, you're sleeping, your body's resting, but your spirit is alive and it's awake and it's doing things. Sometimes you wake up in the night and you're praying. You're interceding for somebody. You didn't even know the name. You're just doing it. But see, the spirit realm is so much more alive than ever. This, what we see. That's why God wants us to see what he sees, right? That's that other song about, you know, that other new song we were singing tonight. And I already forgot the new name. But, okay, thank you. So anyways, Lord, I sat there. I had every song but the last one. I got here in Place of Freedom. That's probably just me because I just love that song. Place of Freedom. God, that's probably just me because I just love that song. And I just, in my head, Place of Freedom, Place of Freedom. And God said, what'd you hear yesterday? I'm free. I know who I used to be. I know what I did. And I'm free. Do you know why I'm free? Because I'm forgiven. He says, sing that song tonight. So I'm listening to it before anybody else gets here. And of course, many of you know that a lot of times God gives me the lyrics of a song to bring into the message. And that's what he did. So I'm going to talk about the lyrics of the song and bring it over to the Bible. And so the first thing that it says is there's a calm that covers me where I kneel down at your feet, a place of healing. It's a place where I find freedom. So in Psalms 91, it says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I, Joyce, will say of the Lord that he, being God, is my refuge and my fortress, my place of safety, my place of peace. You're my God. In him I will trust. Surely he shall deliver me and you from the snare of the fowler. Why? Because the fowler is out there trying to snare us up, trying to get us in places we don't want to go. But God says that he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And so he says that surely he shall cover you, or he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the pestilent. He shall cover you with his feathers. And under his wings, you shall take refuge. God says, that's that place. That's that place in this song. You're covered. You're in the presence of the Most High God. And the thing is, if you know anything about ducks, and I know very little, but they put them under their wings. Birds protect their young. They tuck them under their wings when they're little, you know, and they put them in there and you can't see them and they're protected and it's warm and it's peaceful and the predators can't come and eat them in the middle of the night. They're under their wings. God says, that's us. He loves us so much. We keep peeking our heads up, but I want to see. No, he's tucking us under his wings and protecting us. There's peace in the presence of the Lord. Oh, I could keep going because I love this passage, but I'm not going to because there's a whole lot more where we need to go. But please, if you get an opportunity, read this scripture and personalize it. It will set you to a place in the Holy Spirit you've never been. Because when you realize that God is going to see you through, that 10,000 are going to fall at your side, but none is going to come near your dwelling, that God's going to take care of your children and your families as you're here in Michigan being healed and set free, And being able to allow God to renew your mind so that you can see yourself how he sees you, not how the world has said and the word curses that you grow up with. And as you continue to come here and live in the community, you know, and you grow, you're going to be able to go out and minister the gospel because God has set you to do that. It's amazing. So there's a calm that covers me where I kneel at your feet, a place of healing, a place where I find freedom. Now, if you could just go with me really quick. I want to go to... I think it's John 3:16. Let's go to John 3:16. I'm going back and forth between two scriptures. And please holler out a page number. Okay. So John 3:16, many of us have heard this scripture. It's in red, which means it's Christ talking. It's from God, and it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whomever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life." So I want you to understand something, that God so loved the world in the condition that it is, you in the condition that you're in, me in the condition that I'm in, but he so loves us that he gave the most precious thing so that the rest of the preciousness could come back to him. Because we were created for him. But you see, Jesus Christ paid that price once for all sin, it says. That meant that we are forgiven. And because of that forgiveness, it's the place where we find freedom. You're not going to find freedom in the bar. You're not going to find freedom in promiscuity. You're not going to find it in pornography. You're not going to find it in the casino. You are not going to find it in watching and indulging yourself in soap operas and watching TV until you pass out. You're not going to find it running, because you think if you exercise so much and you just get pretty fanatic about your body, you're not going to think about your spirit. Well, I'm going to tell you, you are a spirit being that lives in a body with a soul, which is your mind, will, and your emotions. You're not going to find peace walking in the woods. You're not going to even find it hunting, because the peace that you really need is the presence of the Almighty God.
Right.
Go with me to John 14. It's just a few over. I've been here many times with this church, and I'll be here many, many times again with it, because this is so powerful. I got so much yellow in this book, I don't know where to start. So in 14 verse 6, it says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Jesus is speaking again. Verse 12, it says, "Most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also, and greater works than these he will do, because I go to the Father. And whatever you ask in my name, I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. If you love me, keep my commandments." See, a lot of times when I first started following Christ, I went to the scripture and I said, "God, you said whatever I ask in your name, I can have. So in Jesus' name, I want that man right there. That's who I want." I'm serious. I did tell him that, because that's what I knew. And I said, everybody's telling me he's bad for me, but I don't see that. But you got to understand, I didn't see me the way Christ seen me. I seen me deserving that kind of treatment and deserving being belittled and deserving being in the place that I was at. So I asked for the bad things. But God so loved the world that he gave his only Son so that I could receive his love, so that I could be in the place with him, so that he could take care of me.
Amen.
And I fought the Lord, and the Lord won. It's true.
Amen.
But I want that car, and I want that house, but I want that job. Well, you can't have that job. But that job is a good job. God, you want me to make good money. Yeah, but you don't know the people that work at that place, and you don't know where that's going to lead you, but I do.
Right.
And you are worth more than the money you're going to make. Wow. Wow. Provider. Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. He knows what we need. So don't be disappointed when you don't get what you want. Ask God to give you peace with his decisions and keep going forward until you get what you need. Because he promises to give you what you need. Okay, so I just want to, it says, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. So part of our love for God is keeping his commandments. Oh, I can't keep the Ten Commandments. I'm telling you now that in Christ we can do all things. And it doesn't matter what you did up to this point. And it's not really about the Ten Commandments. It's about what God says to you. Where you're at, where your personal walk is. God may not allow me to do one thing. Marcy can do it. And I can't judge Marcy because Marcy needs to be where she's at with God. And God will take her to the places she needs to be. I might fall into sin in the places that she can go. But she might fall into sin in the places I can go. And I can do the things that she can't do because it will lead her to sin, but it won't me. It doesn't make her right and me wrong, but what matters is that I'm obedient to the Lord. And I'm not going to do what she does even when I'm with her because she's a Christian and it's okay for her, which is supposed to make it okay for me. No, it's not. My father will tell me what's okay for me and what's not. There's things that I can do that other people can't, but I choose not to because God has told me that if I do that, I could cause another person to stumble. Because they wouldn't understand. So I love you more than being able to do some things. Mm-hmm. I love you more. I care about you more than maybe something I can do. Because it might hurt you. But it's not sin. So we need to listen to God all the time. It says, I will pray to the Father and he will give you another, a helper. And he may abide with you forever. That's the comforter. Can I tell you that Jesus the Father and the Son, and we know this, most of us know this, but nonetheless, they're three parts in one, like water, steam, and ice. Three different forms, but one. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Jesus had to go to heaven because can you imagine one man walking this earth and everybody trying to get to him because he was the only way to get to God? So what he did is he sent the third, the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of the living God lives inside us. Why? Because when you ask Jesus to forgive you of your sins and you believe that he is the Son of the Father, that he died for your sins so you don't have to die for them and be eternally damned, when you believe that, what happens? The spirit that you were born with, the sinful spirit, leaves. According to Ezekiel 36, and what do you get? A brand new one. And then it says that the Spirit of the living God will come and live in you. That's what he does. And he says that he'll cause us to change, that he'll take out our heart and he'll give us a new heart. I don't know about you, my heart was pretty holy and pretty stony. My heart is not anymore. It's pliable and it's thick with love because the living God lives inside of me and he's changed me. And if he can do this with me, he can do this with you. This was the most amazing thing. Verse 19. A little while longer, and the world will see me no more. This is Jesus speaking. But you will see me because I live in you. You will live also. At the day, you will know that I, being God, being Jesus, am in my Father. And you, Marcy, you, Kim, Bear, you, and you in me, and I in you. And he who has my commandments and keeps them, it is he who loves me. See, we can do all things through Christ Jesus. As he changes us, he will cause us to change. And so then we're not going to want to run out and be full of sin and always trying to find love. Why? Because love comes in us. How? Because God is love, and we were created for love, and love comes in us, and love wins. Love wins. If you can understand that love is forgiveness, right? Why? Because God forgave. He gave his son to forgive his creation, all his children, so that they could come unto him. God gave. And he, through his son, forgiveness came. Because he wanted to forgive, but he needed the right sacrifice, the right combination, the right thing. It wasn't going to be animals, and it wasn't going to be sheep, and it wasn't going to be doves. It had to be himself. Himself. Think about it. Water coming out of a faucet. Ice. Steam. It's still water. Jesus is still God. The Father. Jesus is still the Holy Spirit. I know it's hard to wrap our minds about it, but he gave himself. He gave himself for me. He gave himself for you so that we could be free. Why? Because we needed to be forgiven, because we were in a fallen state, because of fall of man, because of being duped by the devil. And so God said, I am going to make a way where there is no other way. Man can't make the way, but I can make the way. I'm going to give myself to my people. And that's what he did. I mean, and this is wonderful. I know I get excited and I holler, but it's just my passion. It's the passion of Christ within me. Why? Because I know, when that guy said yesterday, I know I'm free because I'm forgiven. I know it. I know what I was. I know what I am. I know what I've been. I know it all. I'm forgiven. I'm free. Nobody can hurt me because I'm free. Amen. Huh? Is that you? Can you say that? Is it? It's me. It's me. That's why I'm so radical and I can be so bold, because I know that the Spirit of God is inside of me, and I don't let the devil put me in the corner and kick the crap out of me. I put him in the corner and I kick the crap out of him. Why? Because God said that I am above all things, and guess who's in me? Hello, the great I am. He is above all things. So principalities and powers don't get it, and they cannot have this community, and they can't have the people that God is sending here from the hill. They can't have them, because God brought you here to Michigan to meet the Lord and to be changed forever, so that you know that freedom is in the Spirit of the living God. So please get this one. Get this. See yourself in Christ. See yourself hidden. See yourself forgiven, knowing that, oh my gosh, Jesus went to hell and he kicked the crap out of Satan. And he left them there and he took the keys and he came up and he said, you're free, you're free, you're free, you're free, you're free, you're free. I've got the keys, you're all free, but now you got to walk out of the prisons. Amen. Amen. That is God. Yes, I want to lift my hands until the heavens come down. Yes, I want to shout for joy at the mention of his name. Why? Because I worship him. Can you worship him today with me? Absolutely. Can you see yourself under the feathers of the great I am? That I know that I know. Yeah. Melissa, I see you under his feathers, and I'm going to cry because I'm going to be there with you in prayer, and I see you covered, and I see you protected, and I see God using you mightily, mightily, and he's going to take care of your little chicklins. I want you to know that, and we're going to be here to help you, okay? I want you to know that, because you are free. Yeah. You're free. Free. You're forgiven. Yeah. You're free. Amen. High five, Jesus. Amen. 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 I'm going to cry because I love you and Jesus loves you, and I know what he's done for me, and this church needs to get on fire. We need to get on fire. God wants us to move the wall out, and I'm scared to do it, you're chasing after him, because you're a discipleship class. Not everybody can be there, but you're there because you want more. You want to be used by God, but not for your gain, but for heaven's gain. And I want God to win always in Manistee. He's broken down the powers in this community. And we got to come together in agreement. And that's what that meeting was about yesterday. It was a vision from the Lord. I did my part. Now it's up to everybody else what they do with it. I did my part. And I believe God's going to do it.
Amen.
Because he's done it in the heavenlies.
Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on this earth as it is in heaven. It's done in the heavenlies, and I'm calling it to Manistee, and I'm calling it to River of Life, and I'm calling it to the other churches that are ready to serve God with everything within them. And I pray that he changes the people that just want to sit and do nothing, because they don't know they're free. I pray that the Word of God comes alive to a greater degree. I'm not even going to be able to get through this because the Lord is just like on me. But I know that I'm free. And sometimes I get sad because I miss people when they're gone. I miss people when they leave. I even miss some of you that are here because they can't get to everybody. And I pray that your heart is so tender that you love one another and love me. Because if I don't get to you, or I don't return a phone call, or I don't return a text, it isn't because I don't love you. It's because God has got me super busy. And it's not just doing services, because this is him. It's all him. But there's so much more that's going on for the kingdom of God. And he's asking me to do it. And it isn't because I'm this great, smart, wonderful person who failed school. It's because I will do it. I'll do it afraid. I'll give you words when I don't know who you are. And I'll go and ask these awesome pastors to come to River of Life Ministry. And they're awesome, awesome men and women of God. And I'm seeing myself as myself, as this small person and this broken person that came through the doors. And God is saying, no, I want you to see how I see you. You are a tower, a strong tower, confident in love because you know you're free. And I just want to give that to you from the Word of God, from the heart of God. That's why I'm crying, because God cries. He weeps, even though it's only two. Jesus wept. He cries. Don't let the enemy steal from you anymore. Don't let him put you in a sinking box. Don't let him cap the Spirit of God in your life.
Amen.
Because see, if he can't keep you away from God, but he'll put you in a church, he'll try to get you to do nothing. Not help, don't tithe, be critical. Oh, I'm going to church. Yeah, I'm a Christian. Yeah, what are you doing? I don't know, but you know what? Pastor should have did this, and she didn't do that. And Marcy, she didn't greet too well. Marcy forgot to open the door. And it was raining, and Greg didn't bring out the umbrella. And they're supposed to be bringing out umbrellas when it's raining and help the ladies in. And, oh, they forgot to do this and that. And, oh, is that what you're doing at River of Life? Whoa, you better be careful. Hey, what are you doing at River Life? Oh, my God, it's amazing. You know, we're pressing down the gates. We're believing what God's going to do for the community. And we're just out, you know, we're meeting people. We love them. Worship, we're going to Fire Night. Fire Night's amazing. Fire Night. Let me tell you about Fire Night. Fire Night is not this kind of a service. There's a lot of worship that's going on. There's a lot of singing. It's a lot of personal time for you to press in with God. There's been a theme the past few times. There's a theme this time. And I'm excited about the theme. And I'm laying this afternoon just listening to God and him giving me instructions how to do all of it. And I'm going, Okay, my husband, I'm really glad I got a husband because he's going to be really busy. He's got some stuff he's got to do. You know, not like he's got nothing to do, but you know what? Those things can wait. Those things can wait. Because what's going to happen here tomorrow night or Saturday night is worth the wait.
Yes, to that.
It's worth it. It's worth it. I totally lost my place. See, I'm not a note person anyways, but I actually have, not here, right here, there's like four or five notes. You know what it says? Forgiveness. Freedom. Forgiveness. Do you know you're forgiven? I mean, I know that some things we got to pay for, but do you know you're forgiven? I mean, do you know it? Do you really know it? Are you excited about your forgiveness? Are you walking in the freedom of your forgiveness? Do you know it? If you don't know it today. Amen. Don't leave without the excitement of forgiveness. Don't leave without it.
Glory, glory.
Vision yourself in the Lord. If you know, even as Christians, you know, well, yeah, I ask God to forgive me, but do you know it? Do you know that you're free? Do you know that nobody can condemn you? You've been raised from the dead. Hello? That's what we were living. The lives that we were living. We've been raised from the dead by the glory of the Lord. Don't let the world and the condemnation that comes from the enemy. When people condemn you, look past the person and understand that it is a dark spirit working through a person that maybe is troubled right now. But don't receive that as truth. Why? Because I read it. I, being Christ, am the way, the truth, and the life. And I'm inside of you.
Amen.
I'm the way, I'm the truth, and I'm the life. If you don't find it written in here about you, it's a lie. It's a lie. Period. It's a lie. Amen?
Amen.
I sure didn't go where I thought I was going to go. And that happens to me all the time. But I do want to get Pat, I want to get through these this song, because we're going to close with this song. And I want us to see this song in a new light. It says, there's a place in my eyes. There's a place my eyes can't see. Heaven. Where my spirit longs to be. Why? Why does our spirits long to be there? Now we might, I mean, none of us want to like go to heaven today. All right, I mean, I know that we're supposed to say what we want to. No, I want heaven to come to earth.
Amen.
I want the heaven that's inside of me, the kingdom of heaven that's inside of me, just to bust open and fall all over the earth. I want to see him come. I want to see the glory of the Lord. I want to see the people so excited that when he comes, we really have a party. And we really dance. And we have an awesome time. And we pick up the downhearted and the ones that are fearful. And I pray to God that we can help them. And that's what we should be doing now. And it says, so there's this place that my spirit longs to be. Why? Because we're in the Father. And we don't see it because we can't see in the spirit realm, but that's where we are in Christ. It's a place of healing. It's a place. I live in freedom. See, if you picture yourself living in Christ, like John 14 says right here, it's a place of freedom. That's where you've got to live from. From the Spirit of the living God that's inside of you. You got to live from the freedom that's within you. Not by the freedom that we think that we have in the world, that because we're free to vote and we're free to drive and we're free to work. Well, that's nothing. We're free to live. We're free to dance. We're free to worship. We're free to pray. We're free to take authority over the dominion of the darkness that's coming against our lives and against our families. We got to believe it because it's in us.
Yes.
And we have the power. And God says, I am above all things and I give it. It's yours.
Yes.
It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. And it's from God. It's amazing. It says, it's a place I live in freedom. I'm going to lift my hands till I reach heaven. I'm going to shout your name till the walls come falling down. I've come to worship you, God. I've come to worship you, God, with everything that is in me. There's a love that lives in me for you, Lord. My Savior, King, breaks the sin that's binding? Are you bound up today? You know, I mean, I know that you're a Christian. Most of us in here are saved, but if you haven't been able to see yourself free, man, let's take the chains of bondage that we've allowed to still be there in our lives off.
Yes.
Because we're already free, but we're just bound up in our bodies, and we're bound up in our souls. We're bound up in our minds. We're bound up in our personalities. We're bound up, why? In the flesh, but not in the spirit. We got to let the spirit live and come out and change all this so that we live from a place of freedom that's within us, which is the spirit of the living God, which is in us, with us, changing us. And lead me to the place of freedom. Break the sin that's binding. Sin, it's forgiven, but is there sin that you're dealing with that you're just bound to? You're trying to get past it. You can't. You've tried. You don't want to tell anybody. If that's you tonight, tell somebody. Get it out of here. Because up here is where the shame is and the guilt is and the devil's playground. And you're not telling anybody because you're afraid you're going to be rejected and they're going to hate you and they're never going to trust you. That's a lie. That's what's keeping us in bondage. If you're dealing with a sin, tell somebody. Let them stand in agreement with you and pray the bondage, the chains, the junk, the lies off you, because you are full of truth and you are full of life. Amen. So I'm going to lift my hands till I can reach the heavens. Amen? I'm going to shout your name, Jesus, till the walls come falling down. I literally do that. I shout in here. We were at church last night. We came and visited a church last night, and I had such a hard time. I just have such a hard time containing myself because I'm excited. And I don't have to contain myself, but I really try to be respectful too. But I still was hollering a little bit. But here, y'all get it. I get it in here just by myself. And out there, the weather's getting nicer. The neighbors can hear me. I don't care. Because I'm shouting walls down that are trying to build in front of me. And I am not going to allow that to happen, because the spirit in me is greater than the spirit in the world. And I have authority because Christ gave it to me. And he lives inside of me. And whatever I ask in his name will happen. Will happen, because it's for the glory of the Lord. It's not because of my wants. It's because God has given me something to do for the kingdom of heaven, and that is to break the bondage in people's lives, my life, and this community. Amen. And you are all called to do the same thing. Amen. Let's pray. So God, thank you. I praise you and glorify your name, and I thank you so much for everything that you're doing. I pray leaders, I pray the leaders to rise up. I pray the leaders to rise up in their communities. I pray the leaders to rise up where they're working. I pray the leaders to rise up, Father God, by the Spirit of the living God in the nation. I pray the leaders to rise up by the Spirit of God in Manistee and all around here, Father God. I pray, Lord, that your word comes forth. I pray your power comes forth. I pray your love comes forth. I pray, God, salvation, 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 freedom, that they receive the forgiveness that has so been given by you, Lord, because of your sacrifice on that cross. You gave yourself for me. You gave yourself for this community. You gave yourself for the whole entire world. And I pray, Lord, that our eyes get open and we get excited and we get on fire, God, because I am in the Father. I'm in Christ. Christ is in the Father. You're in me. God, have your way. Have your way. There's no one that can bring me peace but you, that can wash me clean like you, Lord. There is nothing in this world that can make me free. It can't free me. The world can't free me. You saved my soul. So I'm going to lift my hands till they reach the heaven, and I'm going to shout your name until the walls come falling down. And I've come to worship you, God. I've come to worship you, God. And I've come to be on fire for you, and I need my tank filled, and I need you, God, to go with me when I leave this building. And I need you to help me get through the rest of the night and get me through the morning and get me, God, here I am. here. Take me, use me. I'm free because I'm forgiven. In Jesus' name, say that with me. I'm free because I'm forgiven. I'm forgiven.
I'm free.
In Jesus' name. All God's people said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Okay, so this is what I'm hearing. You can take it for me, Greg. Thank you. Okay, so this is really important. This is different, but this is what I believe God wants us to do. If that is you tonight, please come forward. Just stand by me, please. If you don't know that you're free, and this is, don't be afraid of this, because a lot of Christians don't know that they're free because they don't understand forgiveness. Come forward. If you're dealing with a sin that you have just not allowed to be known because the enemy's just told you how bad you are, I want you to come forward. I want you to stand with me. Don't be afraid. I know you're in here. So please just come free. Come and stand with me. I'm standing here because I'm coming for freedom. Thank you.